Hi, this is Lydia and Andy. Here is a video about our epic trip to Italy and France. We essentially started out at Dulles International Airport, flew to Copenhagen, had a very short connection there, but then flew on to Milan, where we rented a car. Be sure to stick around until the end of the video, where we will give you some important travel hacks, especially as it pertains to renting a car in Italy, which we feel like we got scammed and probably paid $600 more than we should have.
Hi, we're at the parking lot.
Yes, we're waiting for a shuttle bus. And there's one, we gotta go.
Okay, so.
Tell me again what's happening in this airport.
Okay, I'm sorry. Yeah, I'm not trying to be, you know, mean or ungrateful, but yeah, Dulles stinks. It smells like mold or something. Yeah.
Anyway, so we're through security and we're going to B40 to catch our flight to Copenhagen.
Yep. Yeah.
So that's what's going to happen next. And we're going to eat a sandwich and get some beer.
It's a Dagwood sandwich.
Yeah. All right. Bye.
Bye. You didn't get any pictures of us at the bar.
I did not. I got it on the phone. Well, we're boarding our flight. I wish we had those Pringles. It's all right. So we're on the plane, and my baby lost her sleep mask.
In like. Literally 2 seconds.
2 seconds.
Like, I took it out of my rucksack, my
and
knapsack.
Then it was gone.
And now
just
I can't find it anywhere.
And she's looking everywhere. And
I'm like, I'm despondent. I'm so mad.
But the loose cannon was great. Close to the wing, so when this thing shears off, the fireball should be kind of sort of behind us. That's what the plan is. Unfortunately, the flight is delayed 15 minutes, meaning we're getting in Copenhagen. Mark, 15 minutes late, and we already have a tight connection. So yeah, we'll see how that's gonna go.
There's been an update.
Oh yeah, we found the mask.
Yay!
So, but now she's gonna go pee, but we're boarding, and that's gonna be a problem. I told her to go earlier.
Why does everything have to be
would
so
she
hard?
Listen? She would listen. You get one loose cannon in this woman, and any sense of any kind of responsibility goes out the window. So. Knowing that now.
Oh, there's a break in traffic.
Oh, there's. Oh, she's coming. Oh, Pete. I'm going to record this. This is going to be funny. You're going to get yelled at. Watch.
No.
Go. Go.
If the aircraft has had to land on water, these slides detach to form rafts. And finally, please take a look at this safety on board card in the seat pocket in front of you.
We landed at Copenhagen Airport without any issues. We had an extremely tight connection, but that all worked out well, and here we are on final approach at the Milan Malpensa Airport. And here's where things are beginning to get interesting. We retrieved our luggage and then headed to the ticket counter for Drivalia. And please watch to the end of the video, and I will show you how you can save at least $600 on a car rental with these folks. And better yet, maybe not even rent from them. We finally did get the Fiat 500 Panda, which we later called the Speed Hamster, poured in all of our luggage and headed on down south to Genoa. So driving in Italy is not for the faint of heart. Thankfully, we got the full insurance, so yeah, I've been pretty much following the model, drive as crazy as they do, and what could possibly go wrong? We did find it absolutely beautiful to see so many different mountain ranges, beautiful forests, so many tunnels. Just a landscape that we were not quite, anticipating, but it was really quite remarkable and beautiful. But yeah, driving here, whew, I don't know. Not for the faint of heart, like I said. We had no issues finding our bed and breakfast called the Garden Suite. It was really great, except for the parking was a little tight. We had a beer and then decided to head into town for a little bit. The bed and breakfast was conveniently located in, I guess what you would call a residential district. It was about a 15-minute walk down to the train station, or going the other way, about a 15-minute walk down to Ferrari Plaza and some of the other sites that we were going to see. Basilica Santa Maria was absolutely impressive. And we were treated to some nice organ music when we walked in. We saw Plaza di Ferrari, some other palazzas, then walked to the Carrugis, which are some really interesting, neat, winding, tiny streets. And then also saw Camp Paisano, where I guess there was a big naval battle in 1284. We saw Christopher Columbus's birthplace. Yep, that's it. And the towers. So this is going to get a little bit confusing. Our bed and breakfast didn't have a place for us to park the car for this particular day. So we drove down to Levanto in hopes of stashing the car either at the train station or at a free parking lot that we've heard about. So we're in beautiful Levanto. We just parked our car here for like 24 hours. We're gonna take the train back to Genoa. And we're gonna hope for the best. Our train back to Genoa wasn't until about 8 p.m., so we decided to walk around town, check out the beach, and then ended up finding a really nice bar, Levanto Bar it was called, and we hung out there, completed some of our trip journals, and just enjoyed hanging out in this town. So while sitting here and relaxing, we came up with a pretty ingenious game plan as it pertains to our rental car. And here it is. All right, so Lydia and I just figured out the optimal parking hack for Levanto. You park in a paid lot, and then around 5 p.m., 5:30 p.m. Everybody leaves, so you can abandon your lot and go to a free parking lot, park your car there, and you could literally stay there for days, mm-hmm. which is what we're planning to possibly do. It's still
plenty of room.
It's still in conversation.
Yeah.
But we're now here waiting for our train back to Genoa. We have cute dogs taking the train. Look at this puppy.
Aww.
It's cute.
He's a seasoned traveler.
He is. Anyway, this is our gift to you, world. This is it.
That's right.
That's where it's coming.
Like and subscribe.
Exactly, and that's where we're going. Ciao.
Hey, there was this like 80-year-old lady pushing a bicycle uphill.
I saw that, and she was huffing and puffing. So we just took the train from Levanto, found a great candy store in the train station of all places, and now we're taking a nice evening walk back to our bed and breakfast.
We wanted to see the Piazza di Ferrari one more time. And the surrounding areas, obviously. So we went down there this time at night, and yeah, it's very, very beautiful. Tomorrow we're going to the Cinque Terre, so I'm very excited about that. Here's another of Bruce Catalano's bronze sculptures that is part of the Les Voyages series. These sculptures were absolutely impressive and so well done. Alright, Lid and I are on our way to the Cinque Terre on yet another train. And Lydia's ordering us the Cinque Terre card so that we can ride all the trains we want. We have arrived in Monterosso. Yeah, this is gonna be a shit show.
So we turned our Cinque Terre trip to a bar crawl. So we're going to have a drink in every town. Mm-hmm. That's the plan.
I think it's a good plan. I think it's the right plan.
Yeah, the sunlight is not quite as nice as we thought it would have been. So we're changing game plan. Of our quest to have five drinks
at each of the Cinque Terre.
Cinque Terre.
Cinque Terre.
Bar crawl.
Si.
Yeah, babe, this is just a little bit too many people. Right? So this is the Via Roma. Babe, Via Roma.
Oh, all roads lead to Rome.
This is it. All right, welcome to
Vernazza.
I love these little boats like that. It's just adorable. Drink number two of the Cinque Terre bar crawl. We're in Vernazza, and we found this cute little place.
Way up on the top of the mountain.
Right, we kind of wanted to.
So we were committed to taking the trail from Vernazza to Corniglia. And well, that's exactly what it did. It turned out to be quite a hike.
Italian Death March, part due.
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 Wow.
Wow.
Whose idea was it to walk from Vernazza?
This guy. This guy.
I don't have the brain width.
With
bandwidth to say the name.
We should have taken the train. Should have read the booklet.
Should have done any kind of research at all.
Anyway, here we are. Only 40,000 more steps to go. And they're all uphill. How much further is it? Pretty good guess.
Pretty far.
Pretty far?
This isn't even halfway.
Oh my god. Oh. We're idiots.
There's a couple bars.
Oh yeah, that's it. That's exactly what we need. Because we just came from one there.
Oh yeah. There's
a bar that's exactly halfway.
Oh yeah. Yeah.
Exactly halfway.
Yeah.
And then it's downhill, right? From there?
Yeah.
Remember, you guys are on the easy part right now. Don't come back this way. Take the train.
Oh yeah.
So the death march has currently been stalled due to kidney failure. We're rehydrating with alcoholic beverages right here. We have a beautiful view and we're heading over there. See that little town right there? That's where we're going. Lydia's dancing.
Cornfolio. After a terrible death march, and we're gonna get a drink.
We were beginning to feel that time was running out, so with some urgency, we took the train down to Riomaggiore, which is the last of the five towns. And that one was absolutely beautiful. And then came back to hit the last town of Manarola on the way back.
Manarola or whatever. Walking down to the water. We completed the Cinque Terre pub crawl.
Pub crawl.
And we actually had a bonus drink in Monterosso.
And a bonus drink at the top of the mountain.
Correct.
So
that's two bonus drinks.
Yeah. If you're counting.
But we made all five towns.
Yeah. It's amazing.
And Vernazza. And Riomaggiore was our favorite.
Yep.
All we gotta do is take a train that's coming from there, going to there.
Yep.
And that's that. And then we're gonna get a salad later.
That's right.
Because we haven't eaten all day.
Insalata. Because we haven't had vegetables in like three days. So
yes, so yeah. There's that.
Yeah. We're malnourished. AF.
Right. But beer counts as nourishment in Germany.
True, it's protein.
So there's that. Yeah. So. Ciao.
After a good night's rest, we headed into Genoa for a day of sightseeing. And I was impressed with the signage at this metro stop. I think it's called Principe.
So today we're just going to spend some time in Genoa. We're going to take some funiculars and just see the general sights. We're just riding on the metro for the first time. Very nice.
We went down to the Genoa Maritime Museum area. I was surprised to see a submarine here. And, well, just wanted to give a shout out to anyone that served on a submarine. That is one thing I don't think I could have done, so thank you all. We took this funicular to get to Albertese Castle. It's kind of neat. It sort of goes flat, maybe slight incline, then goes into a transition area, and then it turns essentially into an elevator, and the entire car lifts up to the top of the street. It's pretty neat.
Some castle, it's beautiful.
The view of Genoa from the D'Albertese Castle grounds was quite impressive. The castle itself was the former home of a sea captain, Enrico Alberto D'Albertese, and upon his death, the castle was donated to the city. He had amassed a spectacular collection of various artifacts during his world travels, and they were all on display. And yeah, we thought the visit was well worth it.
Comes the other one.
It's pretty cool, isn't it? Mm-hmm.
They don't look like they're having fun.
They're not. They're miserable.
Why are they pissed?
Because they're missing lunch on the cruise ship. Pretty cool.
castle, and then we bought some of this, and it is delicious. Oh yeah. All right, I get what the big deal is with this. And now we're thinking about maybe going that way. After visiting the castle, we went back down to the port area. Absolutely beautiful. And then Lydia said, oh, look, this boat sailed here from Boston. And I said, no, they didn't. The old port of Genoa was quite beautiful, and I would highly recommend a visit here. As you can see, there are some rain clouds forming, so we decided to leave the port area, wandered around the streets some more, and then finally got some dinner, and we did this just in time as the skies opened up. So.
It's raining, so we're taking a reprieve and having some lunch. Trying to find that area that looks kind of like the Cinque Terre a little bit.
Hey Italy, what do you have against toilet seats? On our second to last day, we visited an old mariner's fishing village called the Boccadasse, which is also in Genoa. It's quite quaint, beautiful sight. The weather wasn't perfect, but yeah, I'm glad we went and checked it out. I would highly recommend going, especially if you have nice weather. We took the train down to Santa Margherita, very neat city. We spent some time there, had some lunch, and then went over to Portofino by ferry, and that was really nice. But in the meantime, while we were here, we looked at a old cemetery, we had some focaccia, and just did the touristy things, but really enjoyed ourselves here.
Portofino. Ferry from Santa Margherita to Portofino, and it is absolutely beautiful here. Mm-hmm. And now we're going to Castello Brown and check that out, and hoping to get more views of this.
But first, a few more pictures from our ferry crossing. You can definitely tell that Portofino is the playground of the rich and famous. Some of the super yachts that we saw were absolutely amazing. Portofino itself, absolutely gorgeous. I highly recommend you visit there.
Thank you.
So our time in Portofino came to an end way too quickly, but we took the ferry back to Santa Margherita, where we finally had some lunch and a drink. Actually, it was dinner, come to think of it. Yeah, when traveling in Europe, you have to be really careful about the timing of meals, because things just shut down from 2 p.m. until 5 p.m. or so. So finding a meal sometimes is a little difficult.
Crazy dog lady.
Yep.
Anyway, we were in Portofino and it was lovely. And now we're back
in Santa Margherita.
Santa Margherita.
You have to forgive our pronunciations of everything.
Si.
But yeah, we found my favorite wine. Bosco del Merlo Pinot Grigio.
Yes. And I found beer. And we're sitting on the same street that we walked up earlier today. And it's lovely. All kinds of shit we don't need to buy. And we're now just, you know, enjoying the scene.
Mm-hmm.
And gonna have some dinner. And it's beautiful. If you wanted to get broccoli to take home, that would probably be a good place.
We had some time to kill before the train headed back to Genoa, so we did the only sensible thing there is to do. We got another drink. We headed back to Genoa and had our last dance in that beautiful city. That evening we began packing up and had a nice breakfast, and then it was time to check out. We ordered a taxi to take us to the Brignoli station. From there, took a train to Levanto.
We're just hoping that our car is where we expect it to be.
Yep.
Wish us luck. We're in Levanto.
Levanto.
Levanto. Gonna be moment of truth time. Is our car here? This is what two very, very happy and fortunate people look like.
Yay!
So we parked our car here in Levanto in a free parking lot for four days.
Yeah, this was a total faith move.
Yes, and it worked beautifully. The car was there, there's no ticket on it. We just rode the train to the train station here. I walked over there, way, that way some ways, got the car, and now we're on to our next destination, which apparently is Noli. We'll see.
Ciao.
Ciao.
I do want to apologize if we sounded a little bit dismissive about Noli. Noli was a beautiful little town. We took a nice break for lunch, had some focaccia and a beer. Had a little bit of a hard time finding our bed and breakfast. These roads are just extremely tiny and possibly not very well laid out either, but we ended up buying the best cheese that I think I've ever had at a little stand on the beach. Our bed and breakfast was off the beaten path, nestled up in the mountains with beautiful fruit orchards. If we had one complaint, it was just really hard to find, and these roads that you have to travel on are just incredibly tiny.
How are we doing, babe?
I'm filming right now.
Alright, so we're both extremely frustrated at the moment, but we managed to find our next place. And here it is. It's a rather scary drive up these tiny ass roads. But yeah, it is what it is.
Hi. So here's our little welcoming committee. Hi. I know.
But grapes never know.
A couple of tips that I wished I had known about. Number one, get an international driver's license. This is absolutely mandatory and required in Italy. No other European country requires it, but Italy does. Just do it. It will save you a lot of headache at the rental car counter. Number two, it may not be a great idea to bundle your flights and your car together, as you will have no control over the rental car agency that you will actually be using. We use Drivalia, and I would highly recommend that you just stay away from them. And then lastly, number three is just the timing of meals. Be careful, in Europe things will shut down between 2 and 5 p.m. usually. And another issue that we ran into on a Sunday when returning the rental car, a lot of gas stations will be closed. So just keep that in mind. And we're now heading into France, and we will see you there.
Arriving in France.
Here's a quick teaser on what's going to be in the next video. Pretty much a lot of beaches, a lot of maritime little cities. France is a beautiful place. Italy was certainly a beautiful place. So if you like this content, please consider liking and subscribing, and leave a comment below if you have any issues with this Drivalia car rental agency, or if you have some other additional tips that others will find useful. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you soon.